I've never done a live video before, so this is my first one, and thanks for being a part of it.
All right, for those of you who don't know me, I'm Katie Shifkin. I'm teaching at 21st Yoga in Salt Lake City, Utah. Today, this class is going to focus on twists. So it will be a power one and two class with a focus on twists and turns. The props you will need, you won't need any props. I recommend if you do have a block that you can use, I think it's always great to have a block or two handy, but if you don't have one, you don't need one. If you're at home and you have like some big thick books that you could use as blocks or just anything that would work as a prop to kind of bring the ground closer to you, then that's always a great thing to just have close by just in case. And then without further ado, we'll just get started with our practice. So twists, for me, my body doesn't naturally love to twist. It's not something that my body does easily. So it's been really a journey for me in my yoga practice to find kind of the mobility through my center. One of the things that has helped me is just besides yoga practice is breath practice, pranayama. So I know some people don't love pranayama, and so if that's you, then you can just fast forward through this part, or if you're live with me, then you can just like go get your coffee ready or something for a couple minutes. This breath practice that I wanted to do is from Kundalini Yoga. It's just a short Kriya is what it's called. So a short little breath exercise will be twisting. So it will be really good to just kind of get the energy moving and get our lower and middle spine a little more mobile this morning. And if you're doing this at night, whatever your day has looked like. And in the spine, there's all your vertebra, and then in between each vertebra, there's little soft little discs. And keeping our spine moving and keeping our spine mobile, it's really important as we get older to keep those discs kind of soft and supple so they can help with our movement. So this Kriya, it's really simple. You'll just take your fingertips, put them at the front of your shoulders, thumbs in the back. You want to try to get your arms parallel to the ground if possible. Sit up nice and tall. And then notice if when you sat up tall, your ribs came forward. Think of drawing your low ribs in. And all we're going to do is as we twist to the left, breathe in. And as we twist to the right, breathe out. So that's what it looks like. And we're going to go for about 90 seconds. So find your mudra. Fingers in front, thumbs in back. Elbows parallel to the shoulders, nice and tall. Take a big inhale. Big exhale out your mouth. And begin. About 30 more seconds. Your arms down by your sides, find stillness. Close your eyes. Take a great big huge inhale, hold at the top. See if you can seal in that energy. So lock through your pelvic floor, your root lock, your root chakra. And then big sigh out your mouth when you're ready. You can leave your arms just resting by your sides, or if you want, hands to your heart center. Take a moment to find your slow, steady, ujjayi breath. So out through your nose. Gentle constriction in the back of your throat. So think of using the muscles in the back of your throat to slow your breath down and to regulate it. So the same way you would pinch a balloon and let the air out really, really slow, that's what you want to do with your throat and your breath. And then as you sit and find your breath, if there's any little stretches you would like to take, feel free. So maybe it feels good to roll out your shoulders, roll your head from side to side. Maybe you want to get a little more mobile, so maybe you circle your entire torso or take some seated cat-cows. And if you feel like just simply sitting tall and breathing deep, that's fine as well. So take about 3 to 5 more rounds of breath. Either intuitive movement or just stillness. If you are moving, start to find your way back to a neutral spine. And everybody, with your next inhale, reach your arms to the sky. Get as tall as you can. Reach as high as you can. Exhale, draw your hands to your heart. Do that once more. Inhale, reach up. And exhale, hands to heart center. This time, inhale, arms to the sky. And as you exhale, twist to the right, reach your left arm forward and your right arm back. Hold here for a full round of breath, just holding yourself with your own body strength. And then at the end of your exhale, you can bring your hands down. So left hand to the outside of your right thigh, right hand to the ground behind you, or you can push your right hand into your low back. Knees back over your right shoulder and take about 3 rounds. So each time you breathe in, think of lifting, lengthening, like there's a string pulling up on the crown of your head. Each time you exhale, see if you can find that little ringing out sensation from your center. You can use your arms as gentle leverage if it feels good. Take one more round. Twist your edge as you exhale. And then inhale, come back to center and reach your arms to the sky. Exhale, other side. So twist left, right arm reaches forward and left arm reaches back. Full breath. Imagine you're trying to pull your arms in two opposite directions, and then end of your exhalation, hands can come down, right hand outside of your left knee or thigh, and left hand to the ground behind you or a block behind you, or press your left hand into your low back. Gaze over your left shoulder and take some big deep breaths. So especially as we twist, and you breathe all the way down into your belly. You know, it gets a little bit harder to breathe deep in a twist, so put a little extra effort behind it. Sit up taller with your inhale, twist with your exhale, one more round. Inhale to come back to center, arms to the sky. And exhale, hands to your heart. Open your eyes if they're not already, and transition forward onto your hands and your knees. So for now, you can just set any props you have off to the side by tabletop position. So take a moment in your tabletop, cat-cows, hip circles, or even a child's pose. So just creative movement, move with your breath. Maybe you want to close your eyes and just go inward. So what does your body feel? What does your body need? Go there. Move into those tight areas, those tight places. There's no right or wrong. Take a couple more rounds just exploring. Feel the mobility through your spine, through your shoulders, your hips. And then as you're ready, we'll be back in our first downward facing dog. So get there in your own time in your next couple of breaths. And
And as you move into your down dog, do a little body scan. So start with the foundation of your posture, which is your hands. Spread your fingers really, really wide. Grip the ground with the pads of your fingertips. Lots of strength in your shoulders, and then that little bit of lift through your center. So imagine there's a string attached to your belly button, and it's pulling straight up towards the ceiling, up towards the sky. If it feels good, maybe pedal out your heels, shift your weight from side to side. If it feels better to keep a big bend in your knees, that's perfect. If it feels better to straighten out your legs and really stretch, breathe into that space, that's perfect as well. So just take a moment to explore this familiar posture. How does it feel right now in this moment? Take one last big inhale here. And then as you exhale, just crawl your hands to the back of your mat until you find yourself in a forward fold. So all the weight comes into your feet. Bring your feet hips width distance apart if they're not already there. And then next time you breathe in, find your halfway lift. Pause here, spine nice and long. Bend your left knee a lot. Left fingertips to the ground underneath your chest, or you can use a block under your left hand, right arm to the sky twist. Maybe gaze up at your right fingertips. See if you can straighten your right leg a lot and think of pulling your right hip back, but stay rooted through the inner edge of your right foot. Breathe, take two more rounds. With your exhale, see if you can twist just a little bit further. And then end of your second exhalation, slowly unwind and switch sides. So right hand on the ground or a block, right knee bends a lot, left arm reaches up. This time, work on straightening your left leg, pull your left hip back in space, stay rooted through the inner edge of your left foot. Two more big, deep breaths. Perhaps gaze up at your left fingers. And then after your second exhalation, back to your forward fold. Take a moment, maybe ragdoll pose. Perhaps hands behind your head and interlace your fingers. Maybe let your arms dangle, sway a little bit from side to side, bob a little bit up and down. Think of sending your breath up your spinal column and down the backs of your legs, creating space. Next time you inhale, find your halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Plant your hands and crawl them forward to the top of your mat until you're in a high plank, so top of a push-up. Shoulders over wrists, hips level with shoulders. Take a moment here and just be in your plank pose, find your strength. So really think of pressing the ground away. Pull your belly button in and out, breathe into your back body. See if you can rock a little bit forward and back, so just small, tiny little rocks. If you want to bring your knees down to modify at any time, that's absolutely perfect. Take one more big inhale and find that little rock forward, so you're on your tippy-tippy toes. Exhale, lower halfway down. Knees can come to the ground if you want to modify. Inhale, press back up, high plank. Do that one more time. Exhale, lower halfway. Strong arms, strong belly, even strong legs. Inhale, press up. And then exhale, slow as you can go. Lower for 3, 2, and 1, all the way down. Inhale, start with a baby cobra. So tops of your feet root down, shoelace side of your feet. Roll your shoulders back and down, lift your chest. Try to point your elbows at the wall behind you or just back behind you. See if you can hover your hands just a millimeter above the ground. Keep pressing through your shoelaces. Keep breathing. Now notice if your belly button is just letting go and pressing down. See if you can drive your belly button in and up. Press down through your pelvis. Take one more big inhale. And exhale, release. Spider-Man Cobra. So hands come out wide and slightly forward of your shoulders. Lift to your fingertips. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, dip your left shoulder down and gaze over to the right. Inhale, come back through center. Press into your fingertips, elbows face the sky. Exhale, gaze to the left, twist to the left. Dip your right shoulder down. Do that one more time on each side with your own breath. Notice the mobility through your spine, through your shoulder girdle. center, exhale to release. If there's one more back bend you'd like to take, you're more than welcome to. Eventually, everybody finds your way back to downward facing dog, and you can get there however you want. So you can move through a reverse push-up, your tabletop, your child's pose. Once you're back in down dog, give yourself a few deep breaths. Explore your down dog with gentle movement, or explore your down dog in stillness, and just follow the movement of your breath through your body. Take one more great big inhale. This time exhale, look forward. When you're completely empty, step or light hop top of your mat, forward fold. Once you've arrived, inhale, halfway lift. Spine nice and long, back of your neck nice and long. Exhale, fold. Root through your feet, engage your core, lead with your heart, and rise to stand. Inhale, stretch your arms to the sky, grow tall. Exhale, hands to heart center. Flow with your breath, inhale, high mountain. Lead with your heart, slow dive down as you exhale. Inhale, spinal extension, halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Try to get all the rounding out of your back. Exhale, let it go, forward fold. From the press of your feet, reverse swan dive to stand. See if you can pull the tops of your glutes down towards your heels as you rise. Inhale to reach up. Exhale, hands to heart. And we'll do one more just like that. Think of it as a moving meditation. Inhale, reach. Exhale, slow dive. Heart leads. Inhale, halfway lift. Spine parallel to the ground, parallel to the horizon. Exhale, fold. Root to rise all the way up. Inhale, stretch tall, maybe a little gaze up. Exhale, hands to heart. All right, inhale, reach your arms to the sky. Exhale, add just a little baby back bend. So cactus your arms, lift your heart, gaze up. Inhale, re-extend, lengthen. And exhale, follow your breath down slowly. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, fold, plant your hands, step back to plank. Two slow motion push-ups. So inhale at the top. Exhale, lower halfway. Come to your knees if you want. Inhale, press up. Again, just like that. Exhale, halfway down. Try to keep your elbows stacked over your wrists. Inhale, press up. And then exhale all the way down through chaturanga, nice and slow. Inhale, grow into a backbend variation of your choice. You can take an extra breath or two if you'd like. And then when you're ready, back to downward facing dog. All right, from your down dog, inhale your right leg back and up. And then take just a moment here and play around with some movement. So maybe open your right hip, bend your right knee. Maybe you open your right hip and then take a few circles with your right knee through space. If it would feel good to flip your dog, your body feels ready for that, go for it. So just any movement that feels right, or if you just want to keep your right leg extended and strong, that's perfectly fine as well. I think these knee circles are one of the best things we can do for our hips. So try if you want, try to keep every other part of your body very still. And then eventually, everybody, re-extend your right leg to the sky. Get as straight, as strong, as powerful as possible. Take a big, huge inhale and lengthen. Exhale, right knee to your nose, curl in. Keep your hips really high. Stay here as you breathe in. Press the earth away and round your spine. Exhale, softly step your right foot to the top of your yoga mat. And then rise when you're ready, crescent lunge. So front knee over front ankle, rise up. Press down through both feet and think of hugging towards midline. So find your widest stance. I'm gonna widen my stance just a little bit. and then energetically pull front heel back and back toes forward. So you're squeezing towards midline, your low abdominals are toned, your chest is lifted. Breathe here. Okay, one more big inhale. And then as you exhale, twist to the right, left arm forward, right arm back. Bend your back knee and hover it above the ground. Try not to lean forward or reach forward. Stay nice and centered in your weight. Squeeze your inner thighs and think of pulling your right hip towards the back of the room or just back behind you. Maybe gaze back over your right fingertips. Take one more full round and use your exhale to twist a little further. Now listen, end of your exhale, gaze forward, chair pose. So try to keep your right knee bent, step your left foot up to meet your right, arms to the sky, stay low. Weight in your heels, heart lifted, belly tone. Soften your face, soften your shoulders. Take a great big inhale. And as you exhale, chair plane or drinking bird. So hinge forward and reach back, option to float to your tiptoes. See if you can really squeeze the bottom tips of your shoulder blades towards your spine. Point your elbows up at the ceiling and try to magnetize your elbows together behind your back. Take one more full round with breath. And then with your inhale, high mountain, set your heels on the ground, reach your arms to the sky, float your right knee up into space, standing staff. So find balance here. Hug in with your inner thighs. Draw your low abdominals in. Lift your chest and reach super high. Breathe. One more big inhale. Exhale again, twist to the right, left arm forward, right arm back. Hold here. Squeeze your inner thighs. If you want a challenge, so you can gaze back over your right fingertips. If you're falling in and out, that's perfect. Meet yourself where you're at. That's part of your practice today. Take one more full breath. Inhale, back to standing staff. So arms to the sky. Option to kick your right leg forward. Try not to lean back. Exhale, set your right foot down and slowly dive down forward fold. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, fold, plant your hands, step back to the plank, move through a vinyasa. You can add a couple push-ups, you can skip it all together, you can take it on your knees, whatever works for you. We'll see you back in down dog. Inhale, left leg high. And then again, take a moment and explore. So maybe just opening your left hip, holding and breathing. Maybe you open your left hip, and then imagine you've got an invisible washcloth rolled up behind your left knee. Try to squeeze it and bring it out. Now keep that and draw big circles with your left knee through space. This is just an option. You don't have to take it. Rest of your body stays completely still. You're just working the mobility in your left hip joint. Reverse your circles. Stay in your down dog position. So people tend to kind of come forward when they take this movement. Try to keep your right sit bone lifted and pressing back. Go ahead and re-extend your left leg. So wherever you're at, left leg to the sky, straight, strong, and powerful. Spread your toes, big inhale. Exhale, left knee to your nose, round your spine, curl in. Stay here, breathe in, press the earth away, lift your hips higher. Exhale, step your left foot through. Rise when you're ready, crescent lunge. So front knee right over your ankle, back leg straight and strong. Try to center your weight so it doesn't feel like you're leaning forward. Think of drawing your hips back just a little bit. And then lift your heart, reach your arms to the sky. I like to spread my fingers if there's energy shooting out of them. So just feel energy flowing through your body, flowing through your pose. Big deep breaths. One more big inhale. And then as you exhale, twist to the left. So right arm forward, left arm back. Bend your back knee so it hovers above the ground. Think of pulling your back thigh forward and squeeze your inner thighs. See if you can broaden through the front of your collarbones. Maybe gaze back over your left fingertips. One more full round of breath. Use your exhale to twist your edge. End of your exhale, gaze forward. Keep your left knee bent and step forward. Chair pose, arms to the sky. Sit low, weight in your heels. Heart lifted, belly tone. So it feels like you're letting go through your belly and you're pulling your belly button in and up. Squeeze the bottom tips of your shoulder blades towards your spine to keep your heart high. One more big inhale. Exhale, chair plane or drink deeper. So arms reach back, hinge forward. Keep a little lift in your chest like you're doing a baby cobra. Maybe float your heels off the ground. So strong through your ankles, strong through your feet. Breathe. So you can bend your knees more and get even lower. One more round. Inhale, high mountain. Arms reach up, heels on the ground. Straighten your legs. And then float your left knee up. Standing staff, flex your left toes. Squeeze your inner thighs. Drive your low abdominals in. Big huge inhale to reach higher. Exhale, another twist to the left. Right arm forward, left arm back. Keep squeezing your inner thighs. Feel this twist coming from right underneath your rib cage. Option to gaze back over your left fingers. See if you can still breathe really big and deep. One more round. Twist, twist, twist as you exhale. Inhale, standing staff, option to extend your left leg forward. Exhale, set your left foot down, dive down, forward fold. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, plunge your hands, step back to plank, vinyasa, your way. Add push-up, skip it, take it on your knees. See you back in down dog, and once you're there, just take a moment, walk it out, pedal it out, work it out. If you want a quick child's pose, you can take that as well. So just notice, after just a little bit of movement, how does your body feel? After just a little bit of conscious, mindful breath, how does your body feel? If you're in child's pose, meet up with us in down dog. Take one more great big inhale and exhale, look forward, empty out, step or hop, forward fold. Halfway lift once you've arrived, breathe in. Exhale, fold. Root through your feet, engage your core, rise to stand. Inhale, stretch your arms to the sky. Exhale, hands to heart center. All of that breath to movement. Inhale, reach up. Move with intention. Exhale, cactus your arms, lift your heart, keep a little tone through your low belly. Inhale, re-extend your arms, high mountain. And exhale, heart guide, slow dive down, forward fold. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, plant your hands, step to plank, lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Inhale your right leg high, toes spread. Use your core strength. Exhale, step your right foot to the top of your mat. Inhale, slow rise, crescent lunge, strong through your legs. Exhale, slow twist to the right, left arm forward, right arm back, bend your back knee. Look forward, see where you're going. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, chair plane or drinking bird. Option to float to your tiptoes. Inhale, standing staff, right knee lifts, flex your foot. Exhale, twist to the right, left arm forward, right arm back, twist from your center. Inhale, standing staff, maybe right leg extends. Exhale, right foot to the ground, slow dive down, forward fold. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, plant your hands, step or hop to plank, lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, takes you back, down dog. Inhale, your left leg high. Exhale, step through as soft as you can. Inhale, rise up, crescent. Exhale, twist to the left, right arm forward, left arm back, back knee bends. Inhale, chair pose, look forward, step forward. Exhale, chair planer, drinking bird. Inhale, standing staff, left knee lifts. Flex your toes back. Exhale, twist left, right arm forward, left arm back, squeeze your inner thighs. Inhale, standing staff, option to extend your left leg. Exhale, left foot to the ground, follow your breath down slowly. Halfway lift with your inhalation. And with your exhalation, chaturanga dandasana, slowly lower. You can always skip it if you'd rather. Inhale, back bend. Exhale, down dog. Take a great big inhale into your dog pose. Big sigh out your mouth. Inhale, fill up. This time, exhale, look forward, empty out, step or hop, forward fold. Halfway lift, breathe in. Exhale, bow. Root through your feet and rise. Inhale, high mountain arms to the sky. Exhale, hands to heart. We've got one more round. You know it now, so maybe try closing your eyes a little bit and just listening. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, cactus your arms, little baby back bend. Lift your heart, open up. Inhale, arms to the sky. Let your heart guide you all the way down. Exhale, forward fold. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, plant your hands, step or hop back, move through your vinyasa. Skip it if you want. Inhale, lift your heart, shoulders back and down. Exhale, lift your hips. Inhale, your right leg high. Exhale, right foot steps through. Inhale, rise, crescent. Stay strong through your legs. Exhale, twist to the right, left arm forward, right arm back, back knee bends. Inhale, chair pose, gaze forward, step forward. Stay in your legs. Exhale, chair plane or drinking bird, option to float your heels up. Inhale, standing staff, right knee lifts. Exhale, another twist to the right, left arm forward, right arm back. Squeeze your inner thighs. Inhale, standing staff, maybe kick your right leg forward, press that through your heel. Exhale, right foot to the ground, dive down, forward fold. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, plant your hands, step or light hop, move through your vinyasa or skip it. Inhale, open. Exhale, down dog. Big inhale, left leg high. Exhale, step through softly. Crescent lunge with your inhalation, rise. And exhale, twist left. Bend your back knee. Reach forward and back. Look forward. Step forward. Chair, inhale. Exhale, chair plane or drinking bird. Inhale, standing staff, left knee lifts. Active through your left foot and exhale, twist. Squeeze your inner thighs, twist from your center. Maybe gaze back. Inhale, standing staff, option to extend your left leg. Exhale, left foot down, follow your breath down. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, plant your hands, step or float, chaturanga dandasana. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, tabletop, find a kneeling position or a seated position. Great place if you have one to use a block underneath your sit bones. We're going to come back to that breath exercise, that kriya, that we practiced at the very beginning of class. So hands to your shoulders, fingers in front, thumbs in back. Get your arms parallel to the ground. Take a big inhale. Exhale out your mouth. And begin. Inhale to the left. Exhale to the right. Maybe go a little faster this time, a little more momentum. Close your eyes. can go through your mouth.
Sides, big inhale. Hold at the top, seal it in. So tone your pelvic floor. Big exhale, sigh out. Either stay in a seat and simply breathe. Find your slow, steady Ujjayi breath. If you want to move into a child's pose or move into down dog, that is where we will eventually meet. So take about, I don't know, 60 seconds to just come back to your Ujjayi breath, to notice how you feel, to notice the energy moving through you. So pranayama is one of my favorite ways to just get a quick reset. So sometimes when I'm feeling really anxious, just really, I don't know, monkey mind, I'll do just a 90-second breath practice. Kind of recenters you, and then it gives you something to focus on in your body. It really, you can feel that prana just flowing. So as you feel ready, you guys, downward facing dog. From your down dog, inhale your right leg to the sky. Exhale, open your right hip, bend your right knee. If you would like to flip your dog, find a wild thing, go for it. Otherwise, stay here for a couple more rounds. So you can really work the opening through your right hip. Think of stacking right hip on top of left and try not to lean over to the left. If you flipped your dog, slowly find your way back. Everybody, inhale, extend your right leg to the sky. Exhale, right knee to your left elbow. Get as close as you can. Hold for 3, 2, 1. Inhale, back up. Again, just like that, right knee, left elbow. Hold for 3, hips level with shoulders, 2, 1. Inhale, back up. And one more time. Exhale, right knee, left elbow. Keep your chest square to the ground, 3, 2, use your obliques. 1, inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, step your right foot to the top of your yoga mat. All right, you may want to walk underneath your left hand here. Keep your left hand on the ground, reach your right arm to the sky, revolve lunge. So find your revolve lunge first. If you want to stay here, you can. Otherwise, you might need to scoot your left hand back just a little bit. See if you can start to work your right leg towards straight. So think of lifting your right sit bone up and press the top of your right thigh back. Squeeze through your inner thighs, stay balanced on the ball of your back foot, and twist, twist, twist from your center. Breathe. Front leg as straight as it will go. Stay rooted through the inner edge of your right foot, but pull your right hip towards the back wall. Take 2 more big breaths, your fullest expression. It's a variation on the revolve triangle. End of your second exhale, slowly unwind, wide-legged forward fold, facing to the left. So parallel your feet, adjust your stance as much as you need to. Inhale to a halfway lift, and then as you exhale, bend your left knee, keep your right leg straight, and kind of crawl your hands towards the back of your mat. This is a great place to stay, or move into full Skandasana. So you'll turn your left toes just slightly out to the left, and then pivot onto the back of your right heel, right toes face the sky. I like to reach my arms out to the sides or forward with my fingers interlaced. If you know the bind and you're able to go there, go for it. So wherever you're at, a couple more rounds. Think of energetically pulling your heels towards each other so you're not just plopping into it or sinking into it. Next time you inhale, back to center. Nice long spine. Straight legs. Exhale, fold. Take three rounds of breath here. You can explore it in whatever way you want. Maybe you grab hold of the outer edges of your feet or your outer ankles. Peace fingers wrap around your big toes. Inhale to a halfway lift. Fingertips on the ground. Crawl your hands to the top of your mat. Rotate your toes to face forward. All right. You may again want to grab a block here. Warrior three with your hands on the ground or hands on block. So walk your hands forward, float your back leg up, keep your hips square. If it is helpful, bring one of your hands, let's say bring your right hand to your low back and make sure your hips are level. So if your left butt cheek feels way higher than your right butt cheek, how can you adjust that? Maybe you need to lower your left leg a bit and point your left hip straight towards the ground. Keep your left hand on the ground or a block underneath your left shoulder or just slightly forward. Right hand to the crease in your right hip. Now think with your right hand, literally push your right hip back. Think of taking the skin on the inside of your hip and rolling it to the outside. Push it back. So automatically your upper body should start to twist to the right. Eventually reach your right arm to the sky. Revolved half moon. Squeeze your inner thighs, pull your right hip back, stay rooted through the inner edge of your right foot. Maybe gaze up at your right fingertips, maybe lift your back leg higher, make it stronger. Take two more rounds, fullest expression you can find. If it's super uncomfortable, just let it be uncomfortable. End of your next exhale, forward fold. Give your legs a nice little pedal out, your heels lift one at a time, your knees bend one at a time. And then inhale to a halfway lift. Great place to use your block underneath your right hand. Left hand to left hip. Root down through your right foot, extend your left leg back, and then slowly peel your left hip open. So regular half moon should feel relatively good now to open your hips. Bend your left arm to the sky if you want to bind. Bend your left knee, reach back, grab hold of your left foot. About three rounds here. You're holding your left foot, slowly release it. Everybody, see if you can lift your left leg just a tiny bit higher, make it stronger. Big inhale and exhale. Fingertips to the ground or hands to your block, left knee to your nose, curl in. Stay here as you breathe in and sit your left foot down next to right, forward fold again. Pedal out your heels for a moment. Next time you inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Root through your feet, rise to stand. Inhale, arms to the sky. Pause right here. Float your right knee up into space, standing staff. Find your balance first. When you're ready, on an exhale, twist to the right, left arm forward, right arm back. Stay here, or left hand to the outside of your right thigh, or left hand to the outside of your right foot, or peace fingers around your right big toe. Option to start extending your right leg forward, but don't round your spine. So if you can't get your right leg all the way straight, that's fine. I can't get mine straight. I have really tight hamstrings. Squeeze your inner thighs. Breathe. If you want to challenge, gaze back over your right fingertips if you're falling in and out. Your practice today, meet yourself there. Two more rounds. Work your pose with your breath. Very slowly come out the same way you came in. So unwind, arms to the sky. Maybe you extend your right leg forward if it's not already. And set your right foot down, arms come down, shake it out. All right, you guys. Mountain pose, arms by your sides or hands at your heart. Stand up nice and tall with awareness, with intention. Big inhale, hold in fullness. And big sigh out your mouth. Ujjayi breath, inhale, arms to the sky. Exhale, slow dive down. Halfway lift, inhale. clench your hands, step back to plank, move through your vinyasa, and we'll see you in down dog. Take a moment in your down dog. And while you guys are doing that, I'm just going to check these comments and make sure nobody's saying they can't hear me or can't see me. Okay. Looks like everyone's good. All right. From your down dog, inhale, left leg high. And peel your left hip open, bend your left knee. So think left heel towards your right butt cheek, or think of reaching your left foot towards the right side of the room, but try not to lean to the right. If you want to take wild thing, you're welcome to. If you want to stay here and breathe, perfect. If you wanted to take some circles with your left knee, go for it. So if you're working that opening through your hip, think of reaching your left knee to the sky and stack your left hip on top of right. Take one more big inhale. Everybody, left leg extends. So if you're in wild thing, come back, extend your left leg high. Exhale, left knee, right elbow. Hold for three. Keep your hips level with shoulders. Two. High on the ball of your back foot or on your tiptoes. One. Inhale, three-legged dog. Two more times. Exhale, left knee, right elbow. Pull your belly button in and up. Three, two, one. Inhale, back up. Last time, get as close as you can to your elbow. Hold for three. Chest square to the ground. Two. Use your obliques. One. Inhale, back up. Stretch. Exhale, left foot to the top of your mat. Right hand on the ground or right hand on your block. Left arm to the sky. Revolve lunge. Twist from your center. Squeeze your inner thighs. Make your back leg strong and powerful. If you want to stay here, that's perfectly fine. Otherwise, you might need to scoot your right hand back just a little bit. Start to work your left leg towards straight. So think of lifting your left sit bone up. Try to tilt the left side of your pelvis forward. Press the top of your left thigh back. Stay rooted through the inner edge of your left foot and stay balanced on the ball of your back foot. Squeeze your inner thighs. Twist, twist, twist. Breathe. Use your exhales to twist from your center. Twist your edge. Front leg as straight as it will go. Two more rounds. Maybe gaze up at your left hand. So a variation on revolve triangle. End of your second exhale. Slowly unwind, wide-legged fold, facing the right side of your mat. Parallel your feet, straighten out your legs. Inhale, halfway lift, fingertips on the ground, and then bend your right knee. Left leg stays straight. Stay here, you can kind of walk your hands towards your right foot if you want to, or move into full Skandasana. So right toes turn slightly out, and then roll onto the back of your left heel, left toes face the sky, flex. Your left toes towards your shin. Maybe reach your arms out, maybe reach your arms forward, maybe find a half or a full bind if it is beneficial for you and if it's in your practice. About two more big deep breaths. If you're in full Skandasana, energetically pull your heels towards each other so you're not collapsing into it, you're supporting yourself with muscle energy. Next, inhale, back to center, both legs straight, both feet parallel, spine long. Exhale, fold. About three breaths working your wide-legged fold. Think of moving your inner thighs back wide and apart. Root down through the inner and outer edges of your feet. Breathe. Next, inhale, halfway lift, fingertips on the ground. Curl your hands to the top of your mat, back to a lunge position, so rotate your toes to face forward. Great place to grab your block, warrior three, with your fingertips on the ground or your hands on a block. So keep your right hand down, bring your left hand to your low back, and just feel, are your hips level? If not, how can you adjust to make them more level? Maybe you bend your standing leg a little bit, maybe you lower your back leg, your floating leg a little bit. Keep your right hand on the ground or a block underneath your right shoulder, maybe just slightly forward, and left hand to the crease in your left hip. You have taken the skin on the inside of your hip, rolling it out and pushing it back. So think of pushing your left hip back, squeeze your inner thigh, start to twist to the left. Work that twist, eventually left arm to the sky. Keep your back legs straight and strong. Squeeze your inner thighs. Twist from underneath your rib cage. Use your core strength. Take two more rounds. Fullest expression. Work your pose. Back foot active. Reach with your fingertips. End of your second. Exhale. Forward fold. Let it go. For just a moment, kind of wiggle around. Pedal it out. Move your hips from side to side. And then inhale, halfway lift. Grab your block if you're using one. Left hand stays on your block. Right hand to right hip, and slowly extend your right leg back. And then slowly peel your right hip open. So squeeze your outer left hip and stack right hip on top of left. Eventually right arm to the sky. Option to bind if you'd like. Three rounds. If you have your right leg extended, make it strong. Make it support itself. Imagine there's an invisible wall underneath your foot. You're stomping through that wall. So you can let your chest open, your shoulders open, your hips open. If you're holding your right foot, slowly release and re-extend. Great big huge inhale. Lift your right leg higher. Make it stronger, more powerful. And then exhale, fingertips to the ground or hands to your block, right knee to your nose, curl in. Stay here and breathe into your low back. And then set your right foot down next to left. Maybe give your left leg a little shake out. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, fold. Root through your feet. Rise up. Inhale, reach up. Now, last balancing pose. Right foot stays rooted. Left knee floats up. Standing staff. Find your balance first. And then when you're ready, on an exhale, twist to the left. You can stay here, right arm forward, left arm back, or right hand to the outside of your left thigh. You can use that as gentle leverage. Maybe right hand to the outside of your left foot, or peace fingers around your big toe. Start to extend your left leg forward. Keep standing really tall, especially keep length through your spine. Squeeze your inner thighs, twist from your center. Two more rounds of breath, fullest expression. Work your pose with your breath. So you can gaze back over your left hand if you fall in and out. No big deal, that's why it's called a practice. Try to come out just as slow as you came in. Try not to set your left foot down yet. So slowly unwind, arms to the sky, standing staff. Maybe extend your left leg forward if it's not already. Hold for 3, 2, and 1. Let it go. Shake it out. All right, you guys. The worst is over, you made it. Arms by your side, your hands at your heart. Close your eyes. Big, huge inhale, fill up. Hold in fullness, sip in a little bit more. Sip in a little bit more. And big sigh. Ujjayi breath, reach up, breathe in. Lead with your heart, slow dive down. Forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant your hands, step to plank, vinyasa, or however you want to get there, downward facing dog. Take a couple of breaths in your down dog. Inhale, right leg to the sky. Exhale, pigeon pose, right chin to the top of your mat. If you'd rather take this pose in a seat or on your back, choice is yours. If you want to play with any variations, choice is yours. Eventually, bow forward into your humble pigeon. Those slow, deep breaths, moving and flowing. Keep them as smooth as possible. Soften your face. Unclench your jaw. Soften through your forehead and your eyelids.
Take about 4 or 5 more big deep breaths. If you want, last breath or two, you can come out your mouth, big exhales. And then as you're ready, find your way back to your three-legged dog, right leg high. Give it a gentle shake out. And eventually downward facing dog, walk it out. If you want to take a vinyasa to just kind of reset in between sides, you're welcome to. And then everybody, just in your own time, pigeon pose with your left shin forward. Find your way there when you're ready. Take your time to set up, to settle in, to find your alignment. And work with whatever variation will best serve you. Eventually, humble pigeon. Big, deep Ujjayi breath, just a little bit longer. So even as we wind down, try to keep your Ujjayi breath moving, flowing. Create space with it. So visualize your breath moving down into your outer left hip. About 3 more rounds. Exhale out your mouth if you'd like. And then when you feel pretty even on both sides, back to one last three-legged dog and one last downward facing dog. Walk it out in your down dog. If you would like one last vinyasa, take it. Exhale, gently set your knees on the ground, come into a seat first, and then ease your way all the way down onto your back. Once you're there, hug your knees in and rock gently from side to side. And supine spinal twist of your choice, let your knees fall over to the right, left arm reaches out to the left. If there's a different variation you want to take, take it. Gaze up or over your left shoulder, whatever feels better on your neck.
In your next couple of breaths, switch to the other side. Take a moment in between sides to just neutralize. So either rocking a little bit side to side or giving your knees a big squeeze in. And then let your knees fall to the left or take whatever variation you took on the other side. Pretty even on both sides with your twists. Come back onto your spine, find happy baby. Take as many breaths in your happy baby as you want to. If there are any more stretches or poses or movements that your body is calling for, give yourself just a moment to move through them. Eventually, begin settling into your final relaxation. So either the traditional corpse pose, if you want to take seated meditation for Shavasana, that's always a great option, or just any other position that will allow you to relax. And at this point, just let your breath become effortless. Let the weight of your body just be held completely by the ground. Give yourself these last couple of moments to just soak in all the energy and all the efforts from your practice today. Shavasana. Slowly begin to bring small, gentle movements back into your body. And as you're ready, ease your way over onto either side, fetal position. And using the strength in your arms, guide yourself up into a seat.
eyes closed, sit up nice and tall, and gather your hands to your heart center. And take just one last moment, bow your head to your heart. Acknowledge yourself for taking the time out of your day to practice, to slow down, to tune in, to become more present, more grounded, to inhabit your body with your awareness, to connect with your breath. I thank you guys so, so much for tuning in, letting me guide you. The light in me sees and honors the light in you. Namaste. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Please feel free to leave a comment. I'm hoping that this whole practice wasn't sideways. I thought of that like 10 minutes ago because the messages on my phone are coming in sideways. So I hope that this wasn't sideways. If so, we can fix it later. But if it was, apologies. Hopefully you were still able to practice with me. So yeah, just be sure to tell your friends that we're doing classes online at 21st and they can find them on our Facebook page. We also have a YouTube page now, so let's see, if you want to donate, you can use the donation link in the description. Also, you can follow us on Facebook, it's just at 21st Yoga Utah, or IG, Instagram, at 21st Yoga, at 21st underscore yoga. So hopefully I'll see you in the studio soon, I hope. Have a wonderful day. Thanks, guys.